One is ambience. One should have a proper ambience, environmental favor. Second thing is endurance, the withstanding ability. Third thing is patience, to wait for the time and process. Fourth thing is potency, the inherent ability to withstand all of these things, not mere desire to withstand, but also the ability. So these things are the major qualities. So how we are going to start this management? There are two issues, health and happiness. Health and happiness are the first basic couplet on which all the other developments and managements are constructed. Happiness is an internal perfect tool model, and health is the external perfect tool model. If the external tools are complete, perfect, cooperative, amicable, and workable or efficacious, that is what we call health. And the same thing, if it is there, the inner resources, that is known as happiness. And health and happiness is different on the basis of different persons' accessibility, their affordability, their consideration. This creates a lot of diversities and various depths and dimensions in finalizing what is happiness. That is the science of eudaimonics. Eudaimonics is a Vedic science which deals with the process of reserving, preserving, conserving, applying and distributing happiness. Like melancholics are there, agathology is there, aritology is there. So lot of other unexplored regions of the traditional science. We have to conduct a lot of workshops, at least we have to prepare a syllabus and educate these people along with the other called burdens which they are carrying on their heads, emptying their brains. So this major system of happiness, how to get? And health, how to get? There are some levels told in Shastra, it is quite interesting, to have, to get, to achieve and to accomplish. For example, progeny. You know that progeny is very common, and India is very much renowned for the progenic revolution and evolution. And it is the only sorrow for India is that it could not compete or excel China. So progeny is very common. So for those who are inherently, inbuiltly getting those resources, it is to have it. For those people who try, it is to get it. For those people who struggle, it is to achieve it. For those who it is impossible to get it, is to accomplish it. Naturally, the smooth way of getting things is to have it. I have two children. Means it is a very smooth process. I get two children means by observing some fasting, some methodology, some diet, some restriction, some medication, it is to get it. Even if it is challengeable to one's own getting by means of observations, then to achieve it by a struggle. If it is humanly impossible, by penance, contemplation, austerity and ritualistic methodologies, accomplish it. So, to have it and to accomplish it depends upon the person, not in the issue. The same person may be having dozens of children without any effort, any extra effort. And for the same thing, to get one children, that is a pair of children or one child for any other people, who are having some sort of impair in their structure, it is an achievement. For some people who are totally negated and nullified by doctors for the possibility of getting a progeny, it is an accomplishment. So, the management says how to have things normally and how to get things by your effort and how to achieve things by means of an instrumental support and how to get things by means of a metaphysical support. So, one is to procure by effort, second is support, third thing is instrumental support. Fourth thing is mega-technical or meta-technical or metaphysical effort or metaphysical support. So to have, to get and to achieve and accomplish. These are all the major issues in health and happiness. So if we have to be healthy and we have to be happy, it is the nature of us. If we don't have it, we have to get it. If we cannot get it, we have to achieve it. If we cannot achieve by our instrumental, collective, scientific and technological methods, certainly we have to take shelter into the spiritual asylum, wherein by means of the gracious penetration of the transcendental authorities and delegates of the spiritual lineage and scriptural lineage should radiate you with the divine bestowal by which we can accomplish it. So the management deals whether we have to get it, or we have it, or we have to achieve it, or to accomplish it. These four models are very much important. On seeing some other person we could not try, or we should not blindly follow some other model which is not suitable for us. So this is the education, basic education for life management. And this type of stress and strain, how much you work, how long you have to wait, how much you can gain, This is based on a person's status. It is based on a person's stage. It is based on a person's surroundings. This is based on even the sequential order. The strain for a person who is with more sin, it will be more than a normal person. For example, a responsibility of a person to drive a car is different from responsibility of a traffic constable to guide number of cars. So it is a stage, and that is status, and this is surroundings. For example, if a person is driving, the same person driving amidst rain, heavy rain, mist and lack of clarity, that is something which is connected with more induced stress. So that is surrounding and sequential order. How you take, what is your response, that is also there. In Mumbai, bomb blasting was there. It was a feast to the news agencies. And no doubt, it is a loss to Mumbai economy. It is a personal loss of building structure and various things to the concerned owners of the buildings. And it is a target or aim or life mission for the terrorists. The same thing is a turmoil for the victims. So it is not a sequential impact. The same thing, the level of impact, it is different between various issues for various persons. For government, it is responsibility. It is lack of responsibility and the responsibility to install their own responsibility. So for government, they are answerable to the society. News agencies, it is just one more headline in their, that is what we call, one more feather in their cap. It is a mega incident that has wider coverage and more sensation and attraction to the society. Whereas the same sequential impact for a person who has lost their lives or who is connected with the family, suddenly it is a great turmoil. So this impact, life management, we cannot create a common pose. We cannot make hasty generalization. What is the impact of your surroundings? What is the impact of the sequential order, and what is your status or what is your stage, and what is the impact for that? And one more question, how to get these management skills? According to Shastra, they say that it is possible by tradition, paramparagata jnana. So it can be given by tradition, it can be given by parental or academic tuition, it may be given by a receptorial transmission, it may be by intuition, it may be by experience and transformation, it may be by repetition and realization and rectification. So there are six major ways. If you get from your family sources, that is known as tradition. The second thing is to get through a proper way of education. Somebody is educating you how to handle issues. That is known as tuition. Transmission is a divine gift. It is a sanction of divine radiation. And it may be even by transformation, on experiencing the observations of other people, or observing the experiences of other people, we are learning from them and we are transforming ourselves from learning from others. And the final thing is repentance, realization, rectification. Unless we subject ourselves to such melancholy, such a disorder or disastrous calamity, we don't realize. So the possibilities for getting into life management is to, by tradition, by tuition, by intuition, transmission, transformation, repulsion and realization. These are the ways. Then there is a question which is frequently asked by most of the people. It must be philosophically dealt. Do we have in our life something known as selection, option and intervention? Can we select something as per our will? What is selection? There is a random cluster of varieties of things. So amidst that heap of varieties, you can have your own thing. That is known as selection. Option is, there is a limited version that is available before you, which is a medley of varieties. Amidst that distinct or predetermined varieties, you can have a limited selection, which is known as option. How far I can intervene in my life, how far I can select, how far I can opt for things, how far I can deal with the process of intervention. And there is one more question which is connected with the decisional mathematics.